More than 500,000 Canadians are living with dementia, and according to the Alzheimer Society of Canada, that number is expected to double in 15 years. But one startup company is trying to change the way medical professionals screen for the disease, using one's voice and artificial intelligence.
Bottles, and it obviously is a garbage.
It may not look or sound like it, but Joan Deason is taking a test that would detect if she has dementia. The tablet-based assessment is the creation of Winterlight Labs, a Toronto-based startup.
A cat chasing a mouse, and there's a lady there.
By analyzing speech, they can identify cognitive impairment associated with dementia.
We also have a number of tasks that neurologists currently do. So one of them is, can you name as many animals in about a minute? Or can you name words that start with letter F, for instance?
Name as many words starting with the letter A as you can think of.
And so we're able to take those verbal responses and then score them, looking at about 500 different variables.
Assistance.
Tell me everything you see in this picture after the beep.
He looks like he's yelling back at her, which I guess...
So we look at things from the content of her speech, what words you're using, your syntax, your grammar, substitutions that you might be making. So maybe instead of saying someone's name, you say a pronoun instead. He, she, that could indicate they have word find difficulties.
Liam Kaufman is the CEO and co-founder of Winterlight Labs. Before launching the company in 2015, Kaufman was administering pen and paper cognitive assessments to gauge and measure someone who may have dementia.
What I notice is that these assessments are pretty subjective, and so the way that we ultimately determine if someone has a disease or whether a therapy is working is through these sort of subjective, time-consuming methods.
Using artificial intelligence to monitor speech patterns of patients, the program looks at factors like how quickly one talks, how long they pause for, and even fluctuations in the vibration of voices, a consideration a human examiner would miss.
Or remote for the TV.
The paper forms don't pick up on the subtle impairments and they could be anxiety provoking to do, so we just wanted to test whether Winterlight was easier, quicker, and detected more impairment or changes over time.
Winterlight Lab recently wrapped up a 7-month partnership with Rivera, provider of retirement and long-term care homes for seniors. Winterlight Lab collected data from people that were cognitively healthy, had mild cognitive impairment, and people with dementia. There are over 10 different tests available for screening cognitive impairment, like the Mini Mental State Examination or the Montreal Cognitive Assessment.
It actually sets them up for frustration or failure because they believe once they start answering the questions that they're not going to answer them correctly.
Over the sink is an open cupboard. And it has supplies in it.
There'd be a dog, maybe a cat, maybe a bird in a cage or something. You really had to look at it to figure it out. But then all of a sudden, a story falls into place and it makes it so much more interesting.
They were just describing a picture. There's no right or wrong answer. It's not like we ask them to count backwards.
Which is what the Mini Mental State Examination, or the MMSE, asks people to do. One of the 11 questions asks the test taker to count backwards from 100 by sevens, while some questions are simpler, such as read this and do what it says. When someone takes the Winterlight assessment, their voice recording is made into a plain text transcript. Long pauses, repetition, and heavy use of pronouns are all marked by the Winterlight algorithms. The Winterlight test takes only a few minutes to complete, whereas the paper-based assessment can range anywhere from 15 minutes to an hour.
Good. They're long, and some people lose the patience or the ability to pay attention and concentrate on the test.
Besides being a screening tool, the Winterlight assessment can be used to see how patients are responding to different treatments.
People think of dementia as being memory loss solely, but there are other things that go along with it. Loss of the ability to plan and organize and sequence, which is called executive function, and things like banking, grocery shopping, laundry, cooking, and gradually it can progress to things like getting dressed and taking care of your personal hygiene and eating.
Currently, there is no cure for dementia, the most common cause of which is Alzheimer's disease. The winter lights assessment only takes a few minutes to complete and is designed to be administered regularly, which allows examiners to get a better picture of changes in cognition over time. According to the Alzheimer Society of Canada, more than 500,000 Canadians are living with dementia, with 25,000 new cases being diagnosed every year.
It's a problem because we have more and more people being diagnosed with dementia every day. As people continue to age, that number is going to grow exponentially over the next couple of decades. And the important part about diagnosing dementia is to do so early.
I know many people with Alzheimer's, and it's certainly becoming our new cancer of the world. And I think it deserves that. And I'm really pleased to be in on the beginning.
The Agenda with Steve Paikin is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario, helping businesses stay on the right side of change with strategic thinking, insightful decisions, and business leadership. Are you on the right side of change? Ask an Ontario CPA.